Hi everyone, so it's the video you've all been waiting for, the Overlord. In this Overlord, I split up the videos on solos and rallies, and the other video has all the palace battles. So let's get started, and this Overlord, you'll be super excited. I tried a bunch of different combos. Sheik, this is your shout out. Michael, Sheik, King Michael, shout out to you. So awkward, but hello. Okay, so first things first, let's go kill some people. I'm not going to savor the fast pace like last Overlord where everyone kept bubbling, so I'm just going to smash. That wasn't too good of a hit. It's okay. Ooh, good defense. A lot of troops though, that's fine. In the beginning of Overlord, if you have a bunch of teleports, just teleport around and get your hits in. Try different combos, so right now I'm just doing this Gideon and Jason combo that I always do, but I am trying just to smash it because I have so many drops. That wasn't as good as I hoped. Oh yeah, this one was bad because I didn't realize they had all infantry inside their castle, especially T10s blocking it. Oh yeah, and T11 reinforcements. So I will be showing my stats, but I won't be showing my teammate stats because I didn't get any of their permissions to do that. It's just a privacy thing, so you can see my stats. I'm an open book for you guys. So I always have myself a second infantry combo just to... Sometimes a castle has a bunch of infantry, so I do like a double infantry attack. I'll show you. This is my second preset for infantry, which is Faceless and Shrek. Oh wow, yeah. This person barely had anything in their castle, so it's very hard to judge how good their wall was for everyone who's a non-spender watching. I hope this person doesn't bubble. So as a rally caller, you want to make sure you're checking each and every one of your teammates, seeing if they put the correct troops. See, like this person, they put war machines, so it's my job, I have to return it, or else the whole rally gets messed up. Because if you put war machines in the rally, then typically the war machines get all the kills and the infantry don't. I don't know what the new battle logic, if it's the same thing, but yeah. Shout out to 88 for always watching my back and just being the amazing person she is. Shout out to you. Sorry, Sheik, for your awkward shout out earlier. Merp. Did they bubble before I hit? Alright. Like I said in my last video, preset 4. Preset 4 to join rallies. It helps so much. You guys have no idea. You try it out and you'll see. Looks like it's going to be a success. He's not bubbling. He's going to take the hit. And she scores. Oh, he had no heroes on his wall. Why? Why? Okay, let's see. Yeah, because he had no heroes on his wall. His T10 basically had no boost whatsoever. I mean, no boost in defense and HP. Imagine how his teammates would have felt, unless they planned that, but damn, if you're reinforcing your teammate and they had no heroes on the wall, I would feel very merp.
Everything but
If you're new watching my videos, I always look for power, troop kills, troop losses. I will put a few arrows in this video in the beginning just so if you're new you can know exactly what I look out for. I know I go kind of fast, but eventually when you look at it a lot, you kind of just kind of glance at it and then you go for it. Let's hope this person does not bubble so we can test out another infantry hit. And then later throughout the video, you're going to see I did try different combos, so I'm pretty sure you're excited to see that one. But I am taking requests in the comments if you guys wanted to see a specific hero combination that I have and you want to see how well it works, or you want me to test different combos, just leave it all in the comments below. And the next Overlord I will take into consideration, and I will switch up my gems for you guys and heroes just to test out exactly what you want. Obviously, I can't test it all, but I will test as many as possible for the next Overlord. Alright, let's try out some War Machine rallies. Just to see how, with the new battle logic, how well they do, because I know everyone is kind of questioning if War Machines are good or not, since they are free to get now. In the Hero Exchange Hall, you can get Mina and Cho'jin up to 120 really quickly. Ashrai is kind of like another Dolan and Steel Shaper. She just increases stats, so there's no damage with her. Alright, so as a rally caller, remember to always make sure they're sending the correct troops. I had to send JJ back because she sent infantry, and I'm trying to do a War Machine rally right now. Okay, War Machine, perfect, perfect. People are not putting frontline. I have to return this guy. Steel Shaper 120 and Shrek 120 does really good on the wall as well. Especially for non-spenders, you can get Shrek to 120 with the Eaton event really easily now. And Steel Shaper you can get from the Tournament of Kingdoms and the Exchange Hall. So here's the report again. Constantly seeing who are the new people who are joining the rally, seeing if they put the correct troops. As a rally caller, you want to be a good leader. And you want to make sure, you know, you check if any of your people are getting rallied and they're in your rally. See if the timing will be okay for them to put a bubble or to return them. It's your call. Alright, let's just try Ashrai and Beige just for fun. It's like random as hell, but let's just do it because in this Overlord I want to try different combinations, random ones, even if they don't work, because I can't do this in KVK. Overlord's more carefree. That didn't work out too well, but then again, this combination is a little weird, right? Not many people use it, and I can see why. Oh wow, I used War Machine and the cavalry didn't really slaughter my War Machine fully either. Okay, well, I disbanded because that Ice Dragon teleported downwards. She was upwards earlier. She probably thinks I don't notice. But I pay very close attention to that because I actually do that as a trap castle before, as an L2 back in the day. Or even now, actually, I teleport one space just to see if they're paying attention. Okay, well, since that War Machine rally was a bust, let's go probably teleport back to my kingdom somewhere. And then let's find another castle that we can test Mina and Cho'jin again. Because it's something I feel that's very retrievable to everyone, so let's see if it works really well so that you guys can see if it works really well. Oh, this guy, he has a nice Lucky Dragon theme, and it was just Lunar New Year, so maybe we should pick that guy. Yeah, I'm gonna probably pick this guy to rally. He's also using the Crown of Might, which is the throne crown, the blue one. And remember, I told you in that one video previously, if someone uses the throne crown, that means they either forgot to switch, or which makes them a very like red target in my head, like ding ding ding, red target. So I'm just going to go for him. My red target is tingling. Okay, let's hope that he takes this rally. Lego, 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 Ego. All right, I'll stop that now. Okay, so I had to return again because that was infantry. We're doing a war machine rally, another infantry. Have to return his. I got you, JJ. I returned you. From nothing into something. Yeah, something from the dust. Been trying so hard not to let it show. That guy had only 24 million power. Let me switch to infantry. Let's see how this goes. Alright, that's a pretty solid hit. He only killed 267, I killed like 248,000. Oh yeah, he had a lot of T10 infantry, that's why. That's why it was kind of hard. For castles like these, that they don't have any special ability heroes on the wall, I would suggest if you have the extra troops and the extra power to keep soloing them, you'll eventually get them down to zero. But the first two will probably be a fail on your part because they have a lot of T10s inside. It's only when they have special damage heroes that's when it's a little bit more difficult. Okay, let's do some cavalry rallies to test to see how good cavalry really is, because with the new battle logic, with the new update, I feel like cavalry isn't as good as it used to be before the logic came out. But then this month, February is coming, and they are coming out with a new gold hero, Hua Mulan. And she is a cavalry hero. You can read all about her in the game. But at the end of this video, I will slip a picture. So just in case you guys haven't read it yet, you guys can read it through this video. Dang, werewolf's a beast. She's just soloing the entire overlord. She's just killing everybody. Great job, werewolf. Okay, let's try to do a cavalry rally against this 26 million powered castle. It's not too big of a card, so I'm feeling pretty confident about it. But let's see how cavalry is going to go and see what we actually kill in the castle. But as far as I know, if someone attacks you with infantry or does an infantry rally at you and you have cavalry in your castle, they're basically all going to get killed now with the new battle logic compared to before, where you can actually do a cavalry defense against infantry. It's really different now. Like, if you take an infantry rally at you, I would suggest you to take out your cavalry, because if you haven't tested it yet, you can definitely try it out. But my advice to you is just to take the cavalry out, from what I've experienced already. As I was saying earlier, we are trying to test out a bunch of different troops, and why not test out Xinjin? Let's see how, with the new battle logic update, let's see how well mixed rally does and if it's worth doing. I'm just going to put Korra, the old guy, and Shrek on my wall, just because if anybody attacks me, I want to try that random combo. It's not very ideal. It's not something I'll put during KVK, but I wanted to just put a bunch of random heroes together this KVK to test it out. Sorry, I meant Overlord, not KVK. Okay, let's check out this coordinate that Warhead sent. Wow, he has a lot of kills. He had 200 million kills compared to his loss, which was only 70 million. Even though he was 55 million power, you can definitely tell he's an experienced player. Tread carefully. Or, I think that's what they say. So I'm actually not sure what to pair with Xinjin, but I think I'm going to go with Gideon, because I do have Gideon. And I do want my infantry, the T10, to have a little bit more of a damage buff, like, because Gideon, it helps T10 dodge and bring extra damage to spearmen. So That's what I'm hoping to get out of this combo, but let's see. Tells itself, I lay out all my reasons. You'll say that I need help. We all got expectations, and sometimes they go wrong. But no one listens to me, so I put it in this song. They tell me, think with my head, not that thing in my chest. They got their heads, got my neck this time. But you're the one that I want. If that's really so wrong, then they don't know what this feeling is like. My friends say no.
Just noticed, I felt like I was always there for you. Saying this is over, that all you want is closure, and I'm still trying to sell my love to you. It's really been nice to know ya. You fucked this up for sure. There's nothing I can do about it, letting you go. It's really been nice to know ya. I'm fucked up now for sure. There's nothing I can do about it. So tell me all my love's been wasted on you. Tell me I've been wrong for thinking this through. Oh baby, I don't know what else I can do. Cause I need you more than you want me. I need you, need you more than you want me. I need you, need you more than you want me. I need you. Slowly getting over all I gave to you. You still don't have a reason. You talk like I don't need one, and I just wanna figure out the truth. It's really been nice to know ya. Fuck this up for sure. There's nothing I can do about it.
I feel like this Overlord, there's actually a lot of people who don't put heroes. Oh, good job, Bacon. Bacon is a very timid player. He's really shy, so he doesn't attack very often. So it's very good that he's going for it, this Overlord. So the guy I just lost to with the high defense, Yao, the king of 235, is just ported next to this guy, and I think he's avenging me, which is super great. But shout out to Werewolf, who's actually controlling his account today because he can't be here. Still, thank you, Yao's account. Thank you, Werewolf, for avenging me. We're like the Avengers, you know? Yao did it again in the last Overlord. With a solo, he killed over 2.9 million in a solo with heroes. This time with no heroes, seems like he killed 1 million plus. Good job. Those are seriously goals right there. Goals. That's where I want to be. That's where you want to be. We'll get there.
I don't even know. Tried everything, but I don't anymore.
Okay, so I really do want to test out my heroes on my wall. The ones that I put earlier, the random ones. So let's go put a bugle, whatever you guys call it. I call it bugle. And let's see who wants to rally me. I hope, I'm crossing my fingers, that someone will rally me. Shout out to Tumek, he's from Wine Alliance, that's my alliance. Everyone is saying no to me today. Thanks, 88 and Wolf. Maybe if I just give them a bribe that they'll be on YouTube, they'll rally me. Who knows? I'm just having some fun. It's boring if you don't use your buggles, you know. Here's the post that Rock made of Hua Mulan, the new gold cavalry hero that's coming out very soon. She looks exactly like the archer hero. And the next video coming up, it's going to be in a different castle's view. It's going to be from Werewolf. So shout out for Werewolf. Thank you so much for recording and showing us exactly how you fight. Let's just watch together how she fights and how she keeps soloing castle after castle after castle. She just got her Gideon to 120. Congratulations. And she is one of the most positive people I know. She is so forgiving. She makes everyone feel really comfortable, and it's just a nice feeling to be talking to her. So just imagine this sweet girl, but she loves to fight, and that's how I view her as. Like, she's just like the sweet girl, killing, murdering, slaying. She's doing a damn good job at it. She even scared that person a bubble. And this is her first time recording too, so great job, Werewolf. Thank you so much for recording and showing us exactly how you fight.
Free, need your love. down. I know you wanna understand, so I'll explain the best I can what this pain feels like. It's hard, 'cause even as I'm sitting here, I would rather disappear than face the world outside. I'm floating in a violent sky. I'm okay, well maybe not.
Okay, up next we have Yao's point of view, which is the king of the kingdom. Let's see in the eyes of a big, big spender account. And I know every single kingdom has one, but not many people can actually see, you know, how they fight or what's in their castle. Unfortunately, this time we are not seeing Yao himself. We're seeing Werewolf inside his castle. So again, thank you Werewolf for showing us exactly how to use Yao's account and giving us a little snippet of how it's like to be a big spender. Now, everyone was going for that camp like it was the last food item on the dinner table. Everyone's hungry as hell. Jeez, I think I'm hungry right now too. I'm always hungry though.
So I breathe, am I gonna drown?
It's already so exciting to see like the inside of a big castle, to see that, you know, your 446 million power. That's just crazy. I mean, I wish I was rich enough to pour that much in the game, you know. It's pretty awesome. I mean, being rich is one thing, but knowing how to play and understanding the game is a completely different thing.
If I can't come back into my life, you're what I need, that's what I don't like. You're just like my bills, you keep me high. I'm fighting those that only you can put right. I hate your lies, but I love the way you say them all day and night. Your touch, there's no replacement. I wanna fight. Maybe I love the chaos, oh my god. You're like the typo I can't rewrite, so I ain't.
So this is how it's like to see a biggie player smash and smash and smash until someone's zero. Usually I'm the person who, like when I was a smaller castle, I would always get soloed and a lot of big players would try to zero me just like this. So it's pretty exciting seeing the other point of view this time. It's actually bad being in the receiving end actually, but let's not go there. That's why the goal for everybody who's watching videos like this, never be discouraged that you're a non-spender. Your goal should be to look at these videos and check out what heroes can really dodge Bijan, Gideon, and the big players.
I'm sick of chaos, oh my god. You're like the type. You back, babe.
far, it's all wins. This one's a fail. I wonder what was on the wall.
You like the typo.
I can't be right, so
I hit the backspace.
Don't want you back, babe. Don't want to read it. I can't delete it. I hit the backspace. Still want you back, babe.
Well, that's all I have for you for today for this Overlord. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the different point of views from Werewolf and Yao's castle. And I hope you guys got a little bit of something when I was doing a bunch of different rallies with different troops. And let me know in the comments below what kind of troops you would like me to try next for the next Overlord. And thank you so much for helping me reach 100 subscribers. Honestly, I didn't think I would ever make it even to 100. So it's pretty great that people are actually watching it and enjoying themselves. Hopefully there will be more and I can help you in any way possible. All right, well, thanks for watching. Share, like, and subscribe. I would really appreciate it. Zia, wouldn't wanna be ya.